Hello there, my name is Mark, and I'm a PM on the Microsoft Graph team. In this video, I'll share 5 tips and tricks for querying Microsoft Graph. You may know this already, but Microsoft Graph is the API for Microsoft. Whether you want to provision users in Azure Active Directory, retrieve or send emails from Exchange, upload files to OneDrive, or open a web page on your phone with Device Relay, Microsoft Graph has all the data and functionality you need in one API. With one app, you can easily authenticate users with their work or personal account. With one authentication key and one set of docs, you can access user or corporate data from most of Microsoft's cloud products. But here's the best part. You don't even need an app or authentication key to get started. My first tip is to use Graph Explorer to get started. Graph Explorer is available from our developer portal at graph.microsoft.com. Let's see it live. Graph Explorer is a customized HTTP request tool that makes it really easy to discover and execute queries. Along the left nav is a series of categorized requests, and you can click on Show More Samples to add or remove categories. In the main window, you compose your request and view the response. When you type in the URL bar, Graph Explorer will suggest some query options for you to choose. But really, you can issue any query against Graph Explorer, even if the auto-completion doesn't suggest it. Note that if you haven't explicitly logged in, Graph Explorer is logged in with a demo account and will not allow data modification. Fortunately, Graph Explorer supports logging in with a work or personal account, at which point you can modify data, but remember, this is the real deal. Whatever you do through the API is actually happening. My third tip is to learn about the 7 basic operations you can do with graph data and the HTTP methods required to use them. The 7 basic operations are list, get, create, update, delete, invoke, and batch. You can list a collection by using get on a collection URL, or you can get a single item by using get on a collection URL suffixed with an ID. For instance, get users returns a list of all the users in the domain. But get users ID returns just a single user. To create new items, post the new item to the collection URL. In this case, we're creating a new email message with the subject test. To modify items, you typically patch to the resource URL. So now we'll modify this email so that the subject is not test, but hello build 2018. So we'll change to patch hello build 2018. Sending delete to a resource URL will delete the resource. If the resource has an associated recycle bin, like users and groups or files, the resource will be moved there rather than permanently deleted. Sometimes operations are required that don't map to standard CRUD. For instance, there's not a clear HTTP method for verifying a domain. These operations also require special parameters, so they can typically be invoked with post, and the parameters can be put in the body or in the URL. Last but not least, If you have multiple requests you want to execute simultaneously, you can batch them together by sending a post to the special batch endpoint. My fourth tip is to pay attention to server-side pagination. We talked earlier about sending pagination parameters with the request, but you should also be aware that the server will apply pagination by default to reduce the number of records returned. Many of the collections in Graph are already paginated, and other collections will be paginated as they grow larger. You should always be prepared for a collection to be paginated. When the server breaks results into pages, it puts an odata.nextlink URL into each page of results. This URL is considered opaque, so you shouldn't try to modify it, but it can be used to fetch the next page of results. If there is no next link, you are on the final page of results. My fifth and final tip is to investigate whether webhooks and deltas are helpful for your scenarios. Webhooks and deltas are two tools to make some query patterns more efficient. Webhooks allow you to register a URL with Microsoft Graph and configure a notification. You can watch for adds, updates, or deletes on a variety of resource types like users and email. When a change happens, Microsoft Graph will send a message to the URL you registered. This helps to avoid the need to query Microsoft Graph at regular intervals looking for changes. Deltas allow you to request just the changes to a collection of resources. Each of these tools helps you avoid the "Are we there yet?" anti-pattern. When used together, these tools are even more powerful. When Microsoft Graph pokes you with a webhook notification that something has changed, your app can pull down just the changes using Delta. Today, we've learned 5 tips and tricks for querying Microsoft Graph. First, Graph Explorer should be your best friend. You can get started in seconds, and it's a steady companion throughout your development process. Second, it's worth investing some time to learn about the query parameters. Whenever filtering is available in Microsoft Graph, it always uses the same syntax. Third, it's worth understanding the 7 basic operations that Microsoft Graph exposes and how they map to HTTP. Fourth, always be prepared for collections to be paginated by the server. Fifth, look to webhooks and deltas to avoid the "Are we there yet?" anti-pattern. This is just the beginning. For all the details about Microsoft Graph, start at our developer portal, graph.microsoft.com. To play with Graph Explorer, click on the link for Graph Explorer in the top nav, or use the short link aka.ms/GE. You can also tweet using hashtag Microsoft Graph, or contribute to the community samples at aka.ms/graph-community-samples. We can't wait to hear about what you build. Thank you, and happy coding.